Who decided what was the right way to measure feet? And does a size 12 foot mean that it's double the size of a size 6? Well, thank you, John. I think that is such an excellent question. Now, there's no evidence for this, but it is said that Edward I defined an inch as 3 barleycorns, as barleycorns had been a consistent means of measuring small things since Roman times. It is also said that Edward defined the English shoe size as 1 barleycorn, that is 1/3 of an inch. And that is why there are 3 English sizes in an inch to this day. Now, Edward reigned at the end of the 13th century, and in those days, shoes were more like soft bags with stiffer soles. And the shoe adapted itself to the shape of the foot. So sizes and width fittings were quite arbitrary and up to the local shoemakers, as precision sizing was not necessary. Over the centuries, shoemaking became more and more sophisticated until by 1870, the 4 machines necessary to mass produce shoes and boots had been invented in the United States and were up and running in Europe. The first was Isaac Singer's sewing machine that speeded up the making of uppers. Then came Lyman Blake's sole stitching machine, which revolutionized the stitching of soles onto shoes. Farley Gilman, another American, invented the last turning lathe, and that meant the wooden last that shoes are made on could be mass produced in exact sizes and width fittings. And it is the last that gives the shoe its size. The final piece was Jan Mactzalliger's lasting machine, and that could rapidly pull the uppers over the last and the soles. So that's the last piece in the jigsaw of making mass-produced footwear. The mass production, we forget this, the mass production of footwear meant that for the first time in British and European history, most people could afford to wear shoes. Huge change. And that brought the need for very specific measuring systems. And if we want to give names, that's what the question is, if we want to give names to those that defined those measuring systems, then that of Robert Knopfel, editor of the Austrian Footwear News, and F.F. Ehrhardt, professor of medical science at Kyiv University, stand out. They led the way at the Bern General Exhibition of Foot Clothing, which was organized by the Swiss government in 1876 to sort all this stuff out. And it was there that the English size was confirmed as 1/3 of an inch, and it was finally settled that size 5 was 10 inches by definition. And from there, sizes went up and down, 3 sizes to every inch. So going up, size 8 would be 11 inches, and size 11 would be 12 inches. Going down, size 2 was 9 inches. So size 1 was 8 2/3 of an inch. And below that, you had the whole range of child sizes. Child size 13 being 8 1/3 inches. Going down 3 sizes every inch from there, you get to child size 1 at 4 1/3 inches. Hence, in answer to the question, size 6 is not half the length of size 12 because size 6 is 10 1/3 inches. And size 12 is 12 1/3 inches. Therefore, there is only a 2-inch difference between size 12 and size 6. To put it another way, in the 1876 Bern exhibition, the Paris point system was chosen as the official metric size system. There were others. And that system, which we now call continental sizes, does start at 0, and it goes up 3 continental sizes for every 2 centimeters. So size 12 UK is size 47 continental, and size 6 UK is size 39 continental. Another name that can be attributed to the sizing system is that of W.H. Alden, who in 1881 researched thousands of made-to-measure last drafts in London and used them to create a spreadsheet of width fittings, with A,
or 1,
at the narrowest fitting,
double E, or 6,
as the widest fitting, and that was done for each UK shoe size.
Now, the Americans weren't part of the Berne exhibition, and they still retain a slightly different system where a women's size 7 is 10 inches and a men's size 5.5 is 10 inches. And so you have to take that into account when you're buying and selling in America.
I think it was the shoemakers who were the behind-the-scenes creator of sizing systems. And then the academics came along and looked at what the shoemakers were doing. Being academics, they were able to organize what the shoemakers were doing into definable, repeatable systems of measuring. And there we have it, John.